policy. Enjoy the program and hope you received helpful information.
The battle over the planet Earth is coming to an end as the final Khazarian mafia underground bases and strongholds fall, White Dragon Society sources report. However, there is still some heavy-duty last-minute horse trading going on between East and West as the January 20th start of the presidency of Donald Trump approaches, according to sources involved in the negotiations. The future of our planet and our species is what is at stake. The big battle still to be concluded is the one over who exactly will be controlling the process of creating and distributing money, which is the real source of power on this planet. Put another way, what is at stake is the process of deciding what we, as a species, do in the future. With a little over 1 week to go before the Trump presidency begins, it is a good time to take note that, despite his name, he is not the one holding the Trump cards in this high-stakes world poker match. When the US dollar became the de facto world currency after World War II, it was backed by gold and US GDP was worth 50% of world GDP. Now, the so-called US dollar is backed by nothing. The US has no gold, and US GDP, as measured by the IMF, is just 15.6% of world GDP on a purchasing power parity, real, basis. Furthermore, the U.S. was the world's greatest creditor nation at the end of World War II and now it is the most deeply indebted nation in the history of this planet. By contrast, China now controls 17.9% of world GDP, has plenty of gold and is the world's greatest creditor nation. The members of the China-led Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, now over 100 countries, control close to 80% of world GDP while the U.S. and its slave state Japan, the final anti-ABE holdouts, control less than 20%. This means that if China and its Western allies make a grab for control of the world's financial system, they will succeed. However, the U.S. military-industrial complex does have some big cards to play, many of them connected to its secret space and high-tech programs. The U.S. secret government is getting ready to show some of these cards, including much of the technology behind the 6,000 patents that, according to the U.S. Academy of Sciences, have been suppressed for national security reasons, Pentagon officials say. The real question many of us want the answer to, when some of these secrets are revealed is, are two separate realities, one involving space colonization and one earthbound, about to merge into one. There is plenty of evidence, even for the most hard-nosed and fact-based among us, that the official version we are being given of history is full of contradictions and secrets. The WDS Society and their allies will be demanding and receiving answers about things like why manned space exploration suddenly stopped in the 1970s? It is very clear from various accidents that have happened since then that any manned exploration vehicle trying to leave Earth orbit is destroyed, ostensibly by the ionosphere. Agents from the WDS were told by intelligence agency sources with clearance levels high above that of the president of the shallow U.S. state, that the planet has been put under quarantine because some very dangerous entities have taken shelter here after losing an intergalactic war. These entities are now surrendering and freeing the hostage surface population of this planet in the process, these sources say. If what these people are saying is true, then in the near future the benevolent galactic forces will open a wormhole in Antarctica and allow the surface population of humanity contact with the universe at large. That may be why religious, political and science luminaries have been visiting Antarctica recently. This month Russia's Vladimir Putin is expected to be the latest bigwig to visit there. The fact the U.S. has confined all of its aircraft carriers to port, for the first time since World War II, may be a sign of something big about to happen. If so, we can expect some sort of earth-shaking announcement out of Antarctica soon. We shall see. This sounds way too out there many of us to accept but, there can be no doubt a high-level esoteric war has been taking place on the surface of this planet. For one thing, there is plenty of evidence, which would hold up in any court of law or war crimes trial, that the leadership of the Western world has been engaged in mass murder. Let us not go too far back in history, let us even ignore the hundreds of millions of people killed in the 20th century and just look at events since the year 2000. Since then, we have had a regime in the U.S. that has ignored international law and used terror and mass murder to manipulate its own citizens and those of other countries into war. This latest campaign of terror started with the September 11, 2001, 9/11, False flag terror attacks. Since then the U.S. leadership invaded the Middle East and murdered hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people. It has also been spreading biological weapons like HIV, SARS, Ebola, bird flu, etc. in an attempt to start mass pandemics. The Western leadership also used its control of the dollar printing system to try to create mass starvation by bribing farmers into growing fuel instead of food. It has also used earthquake and tsunami causing nuclear weapons against Haiti, Indonesia, Japan, etc. This is mass murder and can be directly linked to people like George Bush Jr., Hillary Clinton, David Rockefeller, etc. Somebody broke into this writer's home recently and attempted to delete all the copies I have of a tape recording of when I was offered the job of finance minister of Japan by a representative of former Japanese finance minister Hisao Takenaka, in exchange for agreeing to participate in a campaign to kill 90% of the world's population. Takenaka works for the Rothschild and Rockefeller Khazarian mafia families behind this plan. I still have many copies of this tape hidden, but the fact they would try to delete this evidence shows clearly how scared of justice these people are. Their increasingly shabby and desperate psychological warfare tactics are also a sign of the deep panic these people are in. Just take a look at last week's pathetic attempt to derail the Trump presidency by asserting, without any evidence, that Russia hacked the U.S. election. This Hail Mary pass attempt to derail the Trump presidency failed utterly, as did their previous vote recount campaign and as will anything else, including Trump assassination, that they might plan. Their fake truck attacks in France, Germany and now Israel are also not producing the desired results. People have become immune to their age-old use of street theater, often including real murder, to manipulate the masses that false flag attacks are now routinely exposed as such within minutes of their being announced. That is because this regime has lost power, thanks to the victory of the military and agency white hat forces behind Trump. We have been promised, and expect, a war crimes trial once Trump takes power. The WDS, for its part, would settle for a South African-style truth and reconciliation committee. There are also some mopping up operations going on in the run-up to Trump's presidency. More deep underground military bases, DUMs, destroyed as cabal who refused amnesty are terminated, was how Pentagon sources described the state of play. Also, New York nuclear arms were disarmed and a Vancouver underground rail demolished, the sources say. The Paris conference on January 15 is also being convened to impose a two-state solution on Israel, the last holdout of the Khazarian mafia, and will use sanctions to force the regime there to really make peace, the sources continue. The world is sick of Israeli tantrums and crimes against humanity, they note. Getting back to the horse trading, the Western military-industrial faction is taking two tacks vis-à-vis the Asians. On one level, they are seeking a Christian alliance with Russia, Europe, the Americas and the Christian parts of Africa to stand equal with the Asians. On another level, they support the creation of a meritocratic, democratic and transparent new world architecture that will make sure international criminal groups like the Khazarian mafia will never again be allowed to foment war, terror and suffering around the planet. Overall, once it has finished removing the criminals from within its ranks, the Western military-industrial complex will offer its technological and military might to the service of humanity as a whole, Pentagon and agency sources say. And so, as the year 2017 begins, so does a new age start to unfold. Let us make it a golden age.
Benjamin Fulford Geopolitical Today update is over. Thank you so much for watching our video. We will be back on 8 a.m. tomorrow. Have a nice day.